Hello, Doys! Welcome back to our channel.
So today we are going to share with you our experience or how we got our permanent residency visa in Australia.
Yay!
Okay, so just to backtrack, we arrived in Australia, particularly in Gold Coast, Queensland, last September 30, 2016. So that's on a student visa. Yep. Now, for details like requirements, expenses, and all the other details about student visa, you can check that one on our previous blog. Video. The title is
How to get an Australian student visa.
Our program was like about 2 years. So the expiry of my student visa was October 2018. While Carl's visa expiry was
December 2018,
so yes. There's a little bit of gap because we don't know. We actually don't know, like maybe because it just depends on the immigration officer who's processing your visa.
That's it.
Yeah. Now, as for me, I went home to the Philippines on July 2018, which was earlier then my visa expiry.
Yep.
But my class was done already at that time, and yep. I was able to submit all the things I need to do
to comply
for my class. So while Carl remained and was left here in Australia.
Yeah, because I was working for a company in Brisbane.
Yeah.
For a construction company in Brisbane. That's why I was left here.
And because my mom got ill that time, and because I was depressed and all, so I decided to just go back to the Philippines.
Yes.
And so nag-LDR muna kami
for like almost a year, I think.
A year and three months.
Yeah.
Exact.
That's really hard.
Yeah. But we made it.
Fortunately, I was sponsored by my employer for the subclass 187 visa. It's a regional skilled migration scheme visa. So what is a 187 visa? This visa allows skilled workers who are nominated by their employer to work in regional Australia and stay there permanently. Regional places in Australia refers to those areas that are away from the big cities like Brisbane, like Melbourne, Sydney, and Newcastle. What else?
You can just actually check the list of that one, but basically there are just a bit of a list of these big cities, and all other places are actually
regional areas.
Yeah.
So there are postcodes there, you can search in Google. There are postcodes for the regional areas.
Yeah. So your job was?
So my job that time was a civil engineer for a construction company. So what I did there is we build roads, highways, and some drainage, like civil works. Or the company is based in Cairns. So Cairns is considered a regional area, and that's why I was sponsored with this visa.
That's right.
What are the steps for the 187 visa processing? Before anything else, please know that this visa requires an accumulated 3 years of permanent full-time experience. And yeah, it could be both overseas, back in your home country, say for example for me from the Philippines, and onshore here in Australia, as long as it is related to the skill that you're applying for. So
in your case?
In my case, I was a civil engineer. So I worked as a civil engineer back, my first permanent full-time job as civil engineer back in the Philippines is 2013. And so we've applied the visa 2018. So that counts about 5 years of permanent full-time experience for me.
Yeah, but your experience at that time, because you were working because we were in a student visa and we could only work part-time, so yung part-time job ni Carl dito was not counted. So in his case, what was counted for 3 years was
the experience back in the Philippines from 2013 to 2016.
Yeah, that's right.
And these are the steps for the 187 visa processing. Number one, I'll look and book for an immigration agent. So my immigration agent is in the Gold Coast. Shout out to This is Australia.
This is Australia. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for assisting us and processing our visa until from the very start until the approval.
Number two,
the migration agent that I was going to process my visa, they sent me a estimate for all the visa payments, and you need to pay first if initial payment, which is in my case I paid about $3,190 for the engagement, so you need to pay that before they can start processing your visa. And after I paid my first initial payment, they provide me the requirements of the visa, and these are the list of the requirements.
When you apply with dependent partner, you also need to submit the supporting document stated here. To summarize, Carl and I were in a de facto relationship when we lodged the subclass 187 visa or RSMS application, but we got married in May 2019 while waiting for the result. Thus, we have submitted both de facto certificate and marriage certificate. Documents showing our joint bank account and other assets were also provided, as well as photos together to prove our relationship since 2015, and two testimonials and a letter from two friends.
Number three, after the migration agent provided me with the requirements, there's also another process that's to be undertaken by my company, my employer, because they need to be assessed as well if they have the capabilities to sponsor an employee. So requirements are like financial statements of the company needs to be in this certain amount, certain dollar amount that they're earning annually, so that they can be able to be approved as a approved sponsor. After my employer submitted the
requirements,
took about, let's say, 3 weeks to be approved, that my employer is approved to sponsor. After that, I provided all the requirements to the migration agent, and then they got back to me with a draft visa application letter. I need to review it. I need to go through it, and after I checked that everything's correct in that draft visa application letter, the migration agent lodged it to the immigration officer, or like immigration office. When the immigration agent lodges your visa, after lodging, automatically you will get the bridging visa A, which allows you to stay in Australia legally.
If your visa expired already.
Even if you're because in my case, the visa expired December 22, and my agent submitted the application December 17.
Yeah, so that was so close.
Yeah, it was so close. So after that, like after the lodgement, automatically I got the bridging visa A. And then when I got the notification of the bridging visa A, I applied for the bridging visa B so that I can travel from Australia back to the Philippines. So it's another cost. It's on top of the visa processing cost, the bridging visa B processing.
How much was that?
It's about $150 Australian dollars.
Okay.
So after that, I think after a day of applying for the bridging visa B, I was approved with the bridging visa B, and after that, I went home for the holidays and Christmas.
Yay!
Yeah, and went back to her. Also, by the way, when the immigration agent submitted my visa application, I need also to pay the balance of the visa processing, which is first payment is about $3,190, and then the second payment, which will incur after the immigration agent submitted your application. Overall, the visa the visa cost for 182 visa is about $13,000.
Yeah, that's
which includes my visa and her visa as well.
Yeah, so how much would that be if it's just you, like you don't have a dependent?
If it's just me, I think it's just be about $10,000 to $11,000. That's the whole cost of the visa.
So basically for the dependent visa it's application about, yeah. it's about 2000. Okay.
After we launched my visa, so I went back to the Philippines for the holidays, December, and went back again here by January to continue my job. And yeah, we waited for like 6 to 7 months, and then just last 4th of July 2019, I received the good news that we are approved of the visa. Yes!
If you're wondering, I was dependent to Carl's visa application, yes, because we were already registered as de facto in Australia before I left.
Yeah, so we've applied the de facto. It's like a common law marriage in the Philippines. It's like a license to have a live-in partner or something
like that. Yeah, it's so almost similar to the certificate is in fact almost similar
to the marriage certificate.
So for the de facto process, we are going to tackle that one on a different vlog, so yes, that it would be detailed. So that is why our visa was processed together and was also approved together, because I was dependent to
the visa that I'm applying for.
He was the main visa applicant and I was the dependent.
Dependent, yes.
If you have dependent, or like if you were processing, like you are the main visa applicant, and then you are processing offshore, or you are in the Philippines or a different part of the world outside Australia, so there is actually a deadline.
A deadline of your first first arrival in Australia. Because if you can't make it, your visa will be
canceled.
Yeah, it will be canceled. Possibly, that's the worst case scenario.
Yeah, or is that automatic margin?
I'm not too sure. I think there's an investigation why you were not able to come back to that deadline. Yeah. But as much as possible.
Yeah, there's a deadline for your first arrival in Australia. Yeah. So which was for me, the deadline was, what was that, June
2020,
year?
Yes, this year.
Yeah, June this year, but I decided to come here mid-October 2020.
Yeah, that's it, with me.
Yeah, so no more LDR.
Yeah. And that's
it.
Very happy.
That's the process we went through on our permanent residency, or the 187 visa, and we are really grateful for that.
Yeah.
There are actually a lot of different visas that you can apply. 187 is just one of the many different types of visas.
There are lots of permanent residency visas as well.
Yeah.
There's also lots of new ones. Not really. You just go to Google, search it, and you can have everything there on the website of Immigration Australia.
Yeah, so what's the website?
The website, which you can go to give you a guide of all the visas out there for Australia, permanent residency and working visas. So go to Immigration and Citizenship website for Australia. It's this one.
Yeah.
Go to this website and
immigrant@homeaffairs.gov.au.
Yes. Go to that website. It can give you a guide on what visas to apply.
Mm-hmm.
Permanent residency, tourist visas, and everything.
No, working visa.
Working visa as well. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's it, mga doys.
So we hope that it was really helpful to you, and this would give you a guide or an idea on how the process looks like for the 187 visa or
the Regional Skilled Migration Visa, RSMS.
Yes. So pretty much that's it. Thank you very much for watching this vlog. Please don't forget to like this video,
subscribe,
comment down below if you have questions. We are willing and would be glad to answer your questions.
Yes.
Please subscribe to our channel, Journey with JNK. We'll see you in our next vlog.
Thank you, mga doys. See ya.
Bye.